This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about solving logarithmic equations. So here's our first equation. This says the log base 5 of 3x minus 1 equals 3. So the whole trick here is going to be to convert this into exponential form. So I'll take the base, which was 5, and make that the base for my exponent. Going to raise that to the third power and set that equal to 3x minus 1. And now it's a fairly easy problem. 5 to the third power, or 5 cubed, is 125. That's going to equal 3x minus 1. I'll just add 1 to both sides. It gives me 126 equals 3x. And then I just divide both sides of the equation by 3. And I'm going to get x equals 42. Okay, so really all I did was take the original logarithmic equation, convert it to exponential form, and solve for x. Okay, here's another one. This says the log base 3 of x plus 3 equals 2 minus the log base 3 of x minus 5. So the first step is going to be to move all of the logs to one side of the equation and keep the constant on the other side. So I'm going to add log base 3 of x minus 5 to both sides. That means the left side of the equation is going to be the log base 3 of x plus 3 plus the log base 3 of x minus 5, and that's going to equal 2. Well, I've got two logs on the left side of the equation. I'm adding them together and they have the same base. So that means I can just multiply this x plus 3 times x minus 5 and convert that all into one logarithm. So that's going to be the log base 3 of, let's see, x times x is x squared. Then I've got an x times negative 5, so it's a negative 5x and a positive 3x. So that's minus 2x, and 3 times negative 5 is negative 15, and that equals 2. Okay, now this gets to be kind of like the first one we did. I'm going to take this logarithmic equation and convert it to exponential form. So the base is 3. I'm going to have 3 raised to the second power equals x squared minus 2x minus 15. Okay, so 3 to the third power is 9. And what I want to do is get a 0 on one side of the equation. So I'm going to subtract 9 from both sides. That means I'm going to have 0 equals x squared minus 2x minus, let's see, 15 minus 9 is negative 24. And now I'll factor this x squared minus 2x minus 24. Is 6 times 4, so I can have x minus 6 and x plus 4. That would factor it out nicely. And I'll set that equal to 0. And now, if I've got x minus 6 as a factor, I'll have x minus 6 equals 0, and x plus 4 equals 0. So for the first equation, I'm going to add 6 to both sides, and I'm going to get x equals 6. And I'll also have x equals negative 4. Now, when you've done something like this, before you assume that both answers are right, go back to your original problem and check those answers. Let's look at what happens if we make x equal to negative 4. Then I've got the log base 3 of negative 4 plus 3. Well, negative 4 plus 3 is negative 1, and we can't take the log of a negative number. The same thing happens with this x minus 5. That would be the log base 3 of negative 4 minus 5, or the log base 3 of negative 9. So this x equals negative 4 is an extraneous answer. We can't use that one. What about x equals 6? Let's see what that would do. That would take this log base 3 of x plus 3 and turn that into, actually, let me just erase some of this, and we'll see how that works. So it's going to turn that into the log base 3 of 6 plus 3 is 9. And we want to see if that equals 2 minus the log base 3 of 6 minus 5. Well, 6 minus 5 is 1. Okay, so the log base 3 of 9, let's assume that log base 3 of 9 equals n. So in exponential form, that's going to be 3 to the n equals 9. So n must be 2. So the log base 3 of 9 would equal 2. And then I'm going to have 2 minus the log base 3 of 1. Well, whenever you're taking a log of 1, you know the answer is going to be 0. So what I've got here is 2 equals 2 minus 0, or 2 equals 2. So x minus 6 is going to be the answer we want to keep. Okay, so for this one, it was really pretty much like the first one, except we had to set it up. We had to get the logs on one side and then combine those logs into one log. We have them equal to some constant. We convert to exponential form, and then we solve it from there. Remember, after you've solved it, to make sure you check your answers to make sure that you don't have anything extraneous in there, like this x equals negative 4. Okay, that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.